Hello and welcome to this video tutorial on distance and displacement by physicscatalyst.com. After watching this video, you would be able to describe position of a particle moving along a straight line, define terms like reference point, distance and displacement, and differentiate between the concept of distance and displacement. I have given links to related study material in the description box, so do check them out for more information. If we want to describe motion of an object, we measure the position, distance, velocity, and other such parameters of the object. Position of an object is measured from some fixed point known as reference point. For example, if a person says the bus is moving, it means that bus is changing its position with respect to this person in a given time interval. In this case, this person is the reference point. So, reference point or origin is defined as a fixed point or fixed object with respect to which the given body changes its position. To describe the position of the particle at a given time, we have to specify its distance from the origin and whether it is in positive direction or negative direction as seen from the origin. Let us now consider an example where a man starts walking towards right of the tree. At t equals to 5 minutes, he covered a distance of 10 meters and then start moving towards the left. Now at t is equals to 8 minutes, he is at a distance of 5 meters from the origin. We will now mark the positions of man at two given instants of time. Here O is the origin. This position is the starting position of the man. Now, at t equals to 5 minutes, man is at 10 meters from the origin. Now, he starts moving towards left, and at t is equals to 8 minutes, he is at 5 meters from the tree or origin. This position is represented by point B. Now, position of man can be negative in the sense that if he keeps moving towards left, cross the tree and is at 4 meter towards left of the tree. At this time, t equals to 15 minutes, his position is represented by point C on the line which is negative. Hence, if the position of the man is at 2 meter from the tree or origin in negative direction, then his position is at x is equals to minus 2 meters. And if he is at 2 meters from the origin towards the right of the tree or in positive direction, then his position is at x equals to 2 meters. Here, this quantity x is called the position of the body. Now that we know how to describe position of a particle or a body moving along a straight line at a given time, we will now learn about distance and displacement. In our day-to-day language, we use terms distance and displacement interchangeably, but in physics, both terms have different meanings. Now, length of the actual path between the initial and final positions of the moving object in the given time interval is known as the distance traveled by the object. To explain this further, let us take a previous example where a man starts moving towards right of the tree. We are using this tree as the reference point. Now at t equals to 10 minutes, he is at 10 meters from the reference point O. Let's call this point as point A. He then starts to move towards left, and at t equals to 8 minutes, he is at 5 meters from the origin. Let's call this point as B. So distance traveled by man in going from O to A is equals to 10 meter, and distance traveled in going from A to B is 5 meter. Total distance traveled is equals to OB. And this OB is equals to OC plus AB. Putting in these values, we get OB is equals to 10 meter plus 5 meter, which is equals to 15 meters. So here we are considering the actual length of path traveled by man between initial points O and final point B. Let us now define term displacement. Displacement is the shortest distance between the initial position and the final position of a moving object in the given interval of time along with its direction. Let us now find the displacement of the man moving from his initial position O to position A and then to position B. Here, to find displacement of the man from initial position to final position, we must have knowledge of how far the final position is from initial position, which is nothing but the straight line distance between the initial position and final position, and the direction of final position as seen from the initial position. So displacement is equal to straight line distance between point O and B, which is equal to OB. Here O is the initial point or position and B is the final point or position. From this figure, displacement is equals to OB, which is equals to 5 meters towards the right of origin O. So this straight line distance between initial and final positions of a particle is called magnitude of the displacement. Also note that we have mentioned the direction in our example, which is towards the right or in right direction of reference point or origin. So displacement has both magnitude and direction, whereas distance traveled has magnitude but no direction. Let us now look at the differences between distance and displacement. First one is, displacement of an object may be zero, but distance traveled by the object is never zero. To explain this further, again consider that in our example, the man travels to point A, then to point B, and finally return to reference point O. Now in this case, distance is equal to OA plus OB plus BO, which is equals to 10 meter plus 5 meter plus 5 meter, which is equals to 20 meters. Now displacement in this case would be zero, since O is the initial point as well as the final point or position of the man. Again, if any object is moving along a circular path, starts at point A and returns back to point A, then total distance covered would be equal to 2 pi r. But net displacement would be equal to 0. So distance traveled by a moving body cannot be 0, but final displacement of a moving body can be 0. We have also discussed earlier that displacement of an object can be positive or negative. But distance traveled by an object can never be negative. Another difference between distance and displacement is that distance is a scalar quantity. That is, it only has magnitude and no direction is specified. Whereas displacement is a vector quantity, as it has both magnitude as well as direction. For example, if a car travels a distance of 60 km, then this 60 km is the distance traveled. Now again, if the car is moving in a straight line towards west, then displacement of the car would be expressed as 50 km towards west. I hope you now have an idea about the terms distance and displacement, along with the difference between the two terms. For more notes and study material, please visit physicscatalyst.com. Thanks for watching.